just how many of these Celtic fans that are on whinging about Peter Lawwell went through the nine in a row the Rangers won? Because I was one of them. And let me tell you, Peter Lawwell was a better signing for Celtic than Henrik Larsson, and they need to get a grip and be thankful for what they've had over the last 12, 13 years. Seriously, they need to take a serious look at themselves.
I didn't think Andy was allowed to be praised higher than Henrik Larsson.
Nah.
What about specifically his son then? Do you think that's been held against Mark? How do you look at the recruitment? What about the news that he's stepped down today?
What were the players that had been identified by Mark Lawwell designed for an Ange Postecoglou system or a Brendan Rodgers system? Brendan Rodgers, to me, again, has been really, really badly maligned by the Celtic supporters. They have to understand that football is now a business. When I was growing up, it didn't matter who you were. You wanted to play for Celtic or Rangers and you would have done it for nothing. They days are gone. They're gone. And they have to have a dose of realism about them.
Andy sounds to me like he's trying to apologise. He's one of the apologists. There's nothing wrong at Celtic, you know, and that people have got to understand that they don't know as much as the people who run the club. Obviously, Brendan Rodgers knows more about football than me or hundreds
glad
of thousands
you
of others.
That up.
Yeah. But, you know, that there have been big mistakes made. Big mistakes costing millions of pounds. And I don't think that Mark Lawwell resigned because it's too cold in Scotland. I think he resigned because his work has been found to be unsatisfactory.
That was that.